Hello, it's Linda here, and thanks very much for joining me again today. I thought today I would show you what I've been experimenting with. Okay, so I've made this pretty card, and as you can see, I've got this beautiful debossed image around here. I'm going to show you what I mean about that in a minute. But I've obtained this by using one of our beautiful new intricate dies. Okay, and I've been playing with my Big Shot and some new embossing mats, and I'm really thrilled that I've managed to achieve this pretty card and this lovely debossed image. On the reverse side of this layer of card, the image is actually embossed, okay, but quite subtly so. So I'm going to show you that as well in a minute, and I'm going to show you how you can obtain a sharper embossed finish if you choose to use the reverse side of this of your cardstock. Okay, so I'm going to pop that to one side. I'm going to show you the die I've been using, and I'm going to go through how to set up your Big Shot with our new embossing mats in order to achieve this fabulous image. So first off, I'm using the new Springtime Impressions Thinlets dies. Okay, so this beautiful die here is the main part, I would say, of the set of three dies. There's two other dies. So we've got a really quite a nice large butterfly die, and I have tried embossing and debossing with this quite successfully as well, and I might put a few cards up on my blog. And there is another little die hiding in this packet somewhere. See if I can find it. Let's have a look. Ooh. See, they get delivered these with lots of sellotape on the inside, and I find that this gets really stuck to it, and I get quite fed up with that actually. So anyway, so that's the other die. So essentially there's three pretty little dies in this pack. Okay. Oh, I'm not going to bother with that again. Let's just pop that to one side. I'll put that away properly later. Okay. So what I did was I took this die and I ran a piece of black cardstock and the die through my Big Shot, and I obtained this. Okay. And that's what we're going to be working with. Now, the card that I have intended to use is actually a C6 size card. So what I've done here is I've taken a piece of 6 by 8.5 inch cardstock, and on the long side I've scored it at 4.25 inches. Okay, and then on the front here I've got a base layer, and this piece measures 5 7/8 inch by 4 1/8 inch. So that's set up ready to take my debossed panel. So here I have a piece of cardstock, and this measures 5 3/4 by 4 inches. And you'll see that that fits on there really nicely, like that. So I'm going to take my Big Shot now and my new embossing mats, which I shall show you. Okay, so these are the embossing mats that have been introduced by Stamping Up. So we've got this big one, and we've got this fairly thick grey rubber mat, and then we've got quite a thin blue rubber mat, or silicon, whatever. And it comes wrapped in a pack with this, and inside you'll see that it gives you different sandwiches to use for different styles of embossing. Okay, so anyway, I'm going to show you what I've done with mine on how I've used it for this today. So I'm bringing in my Big Shot, and to cut my die I used the usual sandwich, which is this, the thin die adapter plate and the base plate. Okay, so I've cut this using that sandwich, obviously my top plate. So in order to now emboss or deboss my die-cut piece of card, what I'm going to do is remove the adapter plate leaving this one. Okay, and then I'm going to take my cardstock and I'm going to lie it down on the top here of my die cut, like that. And then I'm going to take the thick grey rubber or silicone mat, place that down carefully on the top like that, and then I'm taking this plate and I'm going to put that down carefully on the top like that, and I'm just going to simply run it through my Big Shot. And now the reveal. There we go. Now, this is the embossed side. Okay, so you can see it's come out lovely. It's really quite subtle. And I'll just tell you how to obtain maybe a sharper image in a moment. So that is the embossed side. Well, I was interested in using the debossed side. So that's this side. Okay, and as you can see, the impression there is really lovely and crisp. Okay, so I'm going to now use that just to put together this card. Okay, before I do that, I'm going to show you how to obtain maybe a sharper embossed image. So there you go again. That's the debossed side. This is the embossed side. Okay, now I've been playing around and it's a very slight difference really in obtaining the sharper image, and the way that I've achieved it is just to die cut this piece of card. I did it twice. Okay, so you've got two layers of card here, so I cut two of them and then I stuck them together. Okay, so you've got quite a nice thick die cut piece of card now. Look beautiful, just as it is actually on the front of a card, because the dimension is really raised. It's quite a thick piece and it looks stunning, so you could just do that. Okay, but what I'm going to do is put my sandwich together again. So it's just a platform, a cutting plate, and then my card and the die cut, and then just very carefully place that down on the top and then in with this one. Again, we'll just do the reveal, and it's subtly sharper than this one. Okay, that one is not quite so dense. If you actually look at this flower here, it's really quite raised. If you look at the same flower here, it's not quite so. So it's just a little bit. It's a little bit more well defined, really. Okay, and then if you have a look at the debossed image on the other side, that's really sharp as well. Now, I did find when I experimented on my first piece that where I used the thicker die cut, some of the cardstock did actually start to crack, but actually, I have no idea why. But you can see this is beautiful as well. So two very well defined embossed and debossed images there to use on your card. Okay, so I'm going to put mine together now. I'll just do the bit that I prepped here, and I'm going to take this one and I'm just going to stick that onto the front now. All very simple, very quick. It doesn't take a long time at all. I just think it's a really lovely effect that you get. Makes your cards look quite special. I think these would look stunning if you were doing wedding invitations and perhaps what am I trying to say? Wedding invitations, well, just wedding stationery. I think these would be absolutely brilliant. They've just got what I call a nice kind of luxurious quality about them. There you go, that looks absolutely stunning, doesn't it? And so I'm just going to finish off now, like I've done with this one. I wanted to just say, this colour here is Lovely Lipstick. So it's one of the new Stamping Up colours. And this one is Highland Heather, which is another new colour. And I think it's absolutely beautiful. So what I've done is I've used this sentiment, "Oh darling, you are fabulous." I think it's fabulous. I love that. Here. And it's from this stamp set, which is Stitched All Around. And oops, everything's alive. I've already stamped it out here, so I'm just going to quickly die cut that in a moment. And I used my layering ovals, and I just chose a selection of ovals for this. So I've got three here. So I've already used the two biggest ones to cut out these two. So all I'm going to do now is use the smallest of my three just to die cut this sentiment here. Okay, so there we go. So I'm just going to take my glue now. Just get that centered on there. And then I'm going to take this one and stick it direct onto my card base. So you want to get it in the centre. I'm just doing that by eye. And then I've just got some dimensionals here, just to raise that topper. Okay. And I'm just going to get that in the centre of my base oval. And there you just have a really nice card. Nothing difficult about those at all. But I just will say that these new embossing mats, I think they're fantastic. And it just sort of takes your use of your Big Shot sort of up a level, really. It enables you to just get so much more out of it. So those are my two debossed cards. So what I shall just do now, I'm not going to make the whole card up, but I'm just going to use the embossed side now. So this one for this card. Okay, and I'm just going to work out which way to put it on. I think it might actually be nice to do that with it. So yeah, so I should be using this one for another card, which will be winging its way to one of my customers, because what I tend to do is all of the cards and the projects that I use to illustrate my blog and to come on here and just sort of share tips and things with you, they always end up making their way through the post with my thank you packs to my customers. So I do like to try and make sure that the cards are quite nice. A little bit of effort goes into them. And what I do is I send blanks as well, so that they can use my cards themselves if they have an occasion where they have a recipient in mind. They can actually use my cards and write their own messages in them. So there we go. So we've got the embossed image here on this card, and we have debossed images here on my other two cards. And I just wanted to say that colour, if you're wondering, is Berry Burst, which is another fabulous colour from Stamping Up. So those are my cards, and that is how I have been obtaining these really lovely debossed and embossed images using my Big Shot. And so if you haven't tried it, I'd urge you to go away and have a go, because it's great fun as well. You can use any of your intricate dies, really. So, you know, you could be sitting on a whole stash of really fabulous dies that you've just been die cutting to stick directly onto your cards. You could be doing stretching yourself just that little bit further and doing some embossing and debossing. Okay, and this isn't going to go to waste either. I should be using that on another of my cards. So, no wastage here. So, I just think they're really nice tips. And I do hope that you've enjoyed this, and I do hope that you'll pop back for my next project, which is actually a 3D one. Okay, so it's a little box project, which I have promised to a lovely lady called Maria up in Scotland. So anyway, thanks very much for joining me, and if you haven't already done so, I'd love you to hop across and subscribe to my blog, which is www.papercraftwithcrafty.co.uk. There you'll find a link to my 24-hour online store where you can shop for any of the products that you see me using here today. So that's it from me. Bye for now.